The birth of your baby is one of life's most cherished moments. That's why we created the Memorial Family Birthplace. We encourage all moms and their families to tour our facilities before you are in labor. This way, you'll be fully aware of all hospital surroundings, services, rules, and safety precautions. First-time mothers are ready to attend prepared childbirth classes by the 20th week of pregnancy. This class will cover late pregnancy, labor, and postpartum, with breathing and relaxation techniques and comfort measures for pain control. You may register for classes and pay online at mhs.net/familybirthplace. If you're having a planned birth via C-section, your OB surgeon will schedule the surgery date at a time based on the baby's gestational age. If you or your baby are in a high-risk situation, your medical team will take appropriate action in terms of scheduling. Have your hospital bag packed and ready. Make sure you bring your current picture ID and current insurance information. Be prepared to have your infant's car seat installed and secure in your car before discharge. Contact Memorial Patient Financial Services to arrange for insurance and financial payment. Choose a pediatrician for your baby. You will be asked to identify your pediatrician during the admission process. Once your planned birth C-section is scheduled, the pre-admission department will let you know when you should arrive at the hospital, where to check in, and exactly what time you should arrive. Typically, you will be asked to arrive 1.5 to 2 hours before your scheduled surgical birth. After check-in, you will be taken to the pre-op area. In pre-op, you will be prepared for the birth of your baby. A urine specimen will be collected and a blood sample will be drawn. You will have an IV started and a blood pressure cuff put on. A fetal heart monitor will also be attached. Most of the time, mothers choose to be awake during the birth of their baby. In this case, a spinal epidural is given. An anesthesia screen is placed in front of mom to create a sterile environment. Partners are allowed to stay in the surgical area to support you. At Memorial Family Birthplace, we have adopted an OB pre-procedure debriefing.
Timeout, patient Luana Smith.
Based on the FAA's pre-flight checklist, your entire surgical team takes time out to go through your personal checklist of 21 items that ensure everyone in the room is aware of you, your needs, and your safety. The entire team is empowered to be your advocate. Once the anesthesia has taken full effect, the surgery will begin. The baby is usually born within 10 minutes. During the delivery, you will likely feel some tugging sensations in the abdomen, pressure on your chest, or even a pain in your shoulder. As blood is cauterized, you might smell a burning odor. This is all completely normal. After the baby is born, it may take up to an hour to complete the surgery. The baby will be placed skin to skin on the mother's chest. In addition to bonding, this helps increase the blood flow of the baby and increase the flow of birth hormones in the mother, which aids in the flow of milk. During this time, parents and baby each receive matching ID bracelets that remain on you throughout your stay. After surgery, mom is moved to a recovery area for up to 2 hours. If she is awake and alert, she can choose to have the baby with her. A common occurrence after regional anesthesia is to have chills and/or fever. A warm blanket usually helps. A cesarean birth is a major surgery and you will have pain. Even if you are breastfeeding, you will be provided with appropriate pain and comfort medication. The medication that mother takes is proven safe for babies. After the recovery room, mom and baby are taken to a private suite. A normal hospital stay for a cesarean birth is 2 to 3 days. This is longer than the standard 1 to 2 day vaginal birth hospital stay. You may have issues with gas pain, so you will be encouraged to walk as soon as possible to help in recovery and the movement of gas. For your safety and the safety of the baby, the staff will be checking on both of you continuously throughout the day and night. To support rest and recovery, you can discuss other options with your nurse. You can choose to sleep alone while your baby is in the nursery. Your personal needs always take priority. During your recovery at the family birthplace, you'll be provided with educational services to help you prepare for your departure. Our certified lactation consultants and nurses will guide you through breastfeeding techniques and ensure that you're comfortable and ready for success. In addition, we'll help you apply for a birth certificate and social security number for your baby. If you are not married, in the state of Florida, the father of the baby will need a picture ID and will have to sign the paternity birth certificate. When you are ready to leave, ensure that your ID bracelets are visible for checkout. For security purposes, all your bags and belongings will be checked as you depart. Memorial Healthcare System provides support and resources that are available for the entire family. You and your family will be prepared to help identify any issues you might have as a new mom. It's important to know that support is right here.